So, hi dear Aries, a very very good evening to you guys. This is Anjali Tarot and this is a general monthly reading for all the Aries Sun, Moon, Venus, Rising. For the month of July 2024, I'm going to tap into your recent past, current energies and near future, and we will see the guidance as usual. Starting with the overall energy for this particular month, this is going to be a reading from 1st till the 15th of July, you can say till the mid of July. So whatever messages will come, I will just let you guys know. It's not a love reading or career reading or anything specific. Whatever messages will come, I will just let you guys know, okay? Okay, if you want to be a professional tarot card reader like me, you can start your journey by purchasing my course. The link is in the description box for the same. If you want to start your self-healing journey with Ho'oponopono but don't know from where to start, you can definitely start by purchasing my masterclass. Again, the link is in the description box for the same. And if you want one-on-one healing sessions or personal readings, you can check out the description box and you can mail me for the same. So let's start. Aries, for Aries people from 1st till the 15th of July, the overall energy for this month. For Aries people, let's see how it is going to be for you guys, honey. We have the Page of Wands. Okay, you are going to be in this happy-go-lucky kind of energy. You are going to be in this, I think you are going to be in this energy of no matter what, I have to enjoy life. I don't have to take things or people or situations too seriously. Everything is going to be fine. Everything is going to be sorted. Let's take life one day at a time and let's enjoy as much as you can. This is going to be your overall energy. Very good. Fantastic start of this month. Okay, nice. Let's see in the recent past what was happening, honey. Two of Wands. Okay, you were putting something or someone on hold and you were waiting for some kind of energies to show up in your 3D world. It's like deliberate kind of action of taking a break from something or someone, or in this energy of okay, let me pull back and waiting at the same time. Right now, Ten of Cups, the current energy is quite happy, quite determined to make things happy, to make things go in a certain way. Very much focused on emotional fulfillment, emotional happiness and emotional kind of energies. Taking care of yourself or taking care of people who loves you, who wants to be with you and creating a family kind of dynamic. By the 15th of July, we have the Nine of Wands. Okay, you are going to be quite guarded about something or someone and you're going to be in this energy of no matter what, I'm not going to let my guards down. Let's clarify these cards before jumping into any kind of conclusions. Let's clarify the Two of Wands in the recent past for you guys. What was happening there? What were you waiting for? Okay, we have the Tower. And then we have the Temperance. And then the Eight of Pentacles. Okay, see, something happened. And that something actually made you go deeper into yourself. And you were in this energy of, okay, let me learn patience. Let me learn how to be patient with myself. Let me learn how to accept things and people and situations for what they are. Let me put in the effort and energy in this direction of working on myself as much as I can and taking care of myself with a lot of patience, with a lot of love, with a lot of this energy of I can do it. So you went through a Tower moment, you went through something that happened maybe long time ago, but because of that, you were able to teach yourself a lot of patience, a lot of this energy of how to work on yourself and how to work on your energies and how to be with yourself and, you know, be content with yourself kind of a deal. Currently, you are trying to make yourself in a happy-go-lucky kind of energy, creating a family kind of dynamic or trying to find happiness. Okay, let me clarify the Ten of Cups here. We have the Nine of Cups, the Wheel of Fortune. Oh my god, the cards are stuck. The Emperor. See, you are very determined. You are very determined that you are not going to allow anyone or anything to take your happiness away from you. You are in this energy of flipping the page and converting the sadness, transmuting the not so good energies into something beautiful. And you are in this energy of no matter what, no matter what's coming my way, no matter who's coming my way or going out of my way, no matter how life is treating me, I am going to create a wish fulfillment kind of energy for myself. I am going to keep myself happy. I am going to take the charge of my life. I am going to take the charge of my energies. And from this point onwards, I am going to make sure that life is good. I am good. My whole life is a fairy tale kind of a deal. So you are promising yourself to take care of yourself and to take care of your emotional well-being and emotional happiness and creating a life of happiness for yourself. Right now you are in this energy, very 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 beautiful energy, and it's like even if you are the emperor, even if you're very determined, you are very soft. Even if this is the card of being kind of detached and being very practical, for some reason I am getting that your main goal here is to create happiness for yourself and the people you love, and you're very determined to do that, but in a very soft and gentle way. By the 15th of July, we have the Nine of Wands. You're going to be guarded, or you're going to be in this energy of let me protect myself. Let me clarify the Nine of Wands. We have the Empress, the Knight of Wands, and the Knight of Pentacles. Yes, you are going to be in the Empress mode. See, this is the Emperor and this is the Empress. You are going to be in this energy of attracting the right kind of people, right kind of energies towards you. And the people who are going to lower down your energies or your standards, or those who are going to come in way of your productivity and happiness, you are going to be very guarded towards them. I do see that this energy of protecting yourself from indulging in energies or people or situations or connections or things that's not serving you anymore is going to make you look like you are being rude, you are being cold, you are being detached. But at the same time, this is the right thing to do, because you are going to experience a brand new Aries emerging out of this month, because you are not going to take shit from anybody or anything, and it is going to make you look like a villain to some. But at the same time, you are going to create strong boundaries. Your guards are going to be so high for people or situations that's not going to serve you, because you are going to be in the Emperor mode. So you are going to be in this energy of I'm going to attract the Empress kind of energies towards myself. Nothing less than that, nothing more than that, just the right amount of productivity, happiness, just the right amount of thing, energy balance that I want. So you are going to be in this energy of being very guarded about people, things, situation that's not going to serve you. It's a very good energy. It's like guards up and energy is high in this direction of you are going to allow only those kind of energies in your life who is going to serve you for the best. Just give me a second. So basically, you are going to be in this energy of attracting the Emperor to the Empress, Empress to the Emperor. Basically attracting the same kind of vibes and the energies that you are carrying around. Very good, very very good. Wow, very good start. Let's see the guidance for you guys, Aries. We have the Judgment card, the Five of Cups, and the Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, forgiveness. Forgiveness is the virtue that you have to inculcate in this particular month. The more you are going to be in this energy of forgiving yourself, forgiving others, and forgiving the circumstances or people or situation that didn't work out in your favor, the more you are going to grow in your life, in every area of your life actually. You are going to have a lot of abundance, prosperity, and happiness. But all you have to do is to have this energy of forgiveness and gratitude. So gratitude for whatever you have, and forgiveness for whatever you were not able to do. If you are having certain kind of regrets because of whatever happened, like whether it's personal regrets or somebody did something wrong with you, or you did something wrong with somebody, start from the forgiveness exercises and be in this energy of forgiveness as much as you can. That is how you are going to create the life of your dreams. It's like creating the life of your dreams, starting the first step towards creating the life of your dreams, Aries. Very good, very very good, fantastic reading. Thank you so much. So I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye, take care, God bless you, namaste.